Just 1 week until Texas fully reopens. And tonight, there are still so many questions.
Yeah, like what will school districts decide? Can business owners require you to mask up? We're working to get answers. Tonight, we have live team coverage. James Grant is talking with Southeast Texas restaurant owners as they navigate this new territory.
First, let's turn to Jordan James, who's following the new guidance that the TEA is issuing for area schools.
Yeah, Jordan, yesterday, Southeast Texas district leaders were faced with a difficult decision. Do they keep the mask, ease restrictions, or do they wait for the Texas Education Agency? Well, they did not have to wait very long. The agency released this statement this afternoon saying a public school system's current practices on mask may continue unchanged, but local school boards have full authority to determine whether to keep the mask policy. In short, school districts can keep doing what they've been doing. If they would like to eliminate masks, the school board must vote to modify or change it. Currently, the only school district to commit to a no mask policy is Lumberton. As for colleges and university, the Texas Faculty Association is urging the governor to keep a statewide mask mandate on their campuses, saying in part, quote, Governor Abbott is jeopardizing the health and lives of countless Texans, including many students, teachers, and staff on higher education campuses. They're asking the governor to keep the mask mandate until more vaccines arrive for more people to get a shot. Back out here live, if you have any more questions about your child's school, on our website, we have a breakdown of district by district. Reporting here live in Lumberton, Jordan James, 12 News.
Thank you, sir. Right now, all Texas teachers are eligible to get the COVID vaccine. The Texas Department of State Health Services notified all vaccine providers today that they should immediately include school teachers, staff, and child care workers in the vaccine administration line. This move comes at the direction of the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
We're really encouraging those restaurants to look at their local area, to talk to their guests that they've built a relationship with, and even more importantly, to talk with their employees.
In about a week, Southeast Texas restaurant owners have a decision to make. Will they allow customers inside without having to wear a mask? Some local owners are conflicted. They say the governor's decision may ease their financial burden.
But they also admit it could possibly jeopardize the health and safety of their staff and customers. Tonight, 12 News reporter James Grant continues our team coverage. He's putting things into perspective.
Robbie Valvano with Madison's on Dallin says his restaurant will open at 100% capacity next Wednesday. They'll encourage their staff and patrons to wear masks, but they won't be required.
If you want to wear a mask, wear a mask. If you don't, you know, the governor says you don't have to anymore.
Valvano says while capacity may soon be full and masks optional, they'll closely monitor the local cases.
We're gonna keep an eye on case counts and, you know, make sure that we're doing what's the responsible thing to do as operators.
The Madison's regional manager says easing COVID restrictions offers relief to those in the service industry who've been hit especially hard by the pandemic.
It's been a struggle. I think there's not a person in the service industry or the restaurant and hospitality business that would tell you this year has been easy.
Meanwhile, Dallin James, who owns Crown Pizza and Willy Burger, says he will require his staff to continue wearing masks, but not his customers.
We are pleased with the governor opening up businesses to 100%. My personal preference would have been that we continue to require masks until we get a little bit more of our population vaccinated.
Both owners say they're thankful to have survived the pandemic, and now they're working to rebuild as things slowly get back to normal.
We've got a very resilient staff at all of our locations. We've got a great customer base, great customer community support, and you know, we've been very fortunate.
Both Valvano and James say they're fortunate. They haven't had to lay anyone off since the pandemic started, but it's been a struggle, and they're hopeful they can open back up responsibly and keep their business alive and their customers safe. In Beaumont, James Grant, 12 News.
Well, today, Southeast Texas hospitals are doubling down on mask mandates. The Medical Center of Southeast Texas, Christus, and Baptist all saying there are no changes to their mask policies. Christus and Baptist releasing similar statements today, saying their top priorities are to keep Southeast Texans safe.
We turn now to your storm tracker forecast. Wasn't today absolutely amazing? A live look outside at our roofing 911 Skycam. You saw the view in Beaumont, and here's the one in Orange over at the Horseman. Our chief meteorologist, Patrick Vaughn, in the Storm Tracker Center tonight. We wish that this could just go on a few more days.
I love talking about days like today,
right?
Because they are just few and far between. It's been a wonderful day weather-wise, and the nice thing is that we get another day like today coming up tomorrow. Temperatures cooling off, though. Now down to 57 into Port Arthur, otherwise into the lower and middle 60s under clear skies. And that humidity certainly get a break from the grasps of the Gulf of Mexico with low humidity out there. We expect temperatures to fall to near 60 by 7 p.m. here in Beaumont, down to 50 by 11 p.m. Going to be another chilly night across southeast Texas, but not as frosty as this morning. Near 40 in the lakes, the low to mid 40s in the triangle. Coming up, we'll talk about a cold front and what it means to our weekend forecast shortly on 12 News.